I have a 1997 Ford Econoline E-Superduty that came with Velvac standard towing mirrors. I wanted to upgrade to power mirrors, and mirrors from a 1992 to 2002 will fit this door, but it seemed like power mirrors in those years were very expensive. I actually got a quote from the company that makes these mirrors, Velvac, and they quoted me $1,200 for both of them. I noticed that power mirrors from the next model year, 2003 to 2014, were in abundance on eBay for the Econoline series, so I looked online to see if anyone could tell me if these mirrors were compatible. I was unable to find any information, so I decided to try the conversion myself, and if I could get them to fit, I would make this video to help others. It turns out the mirrors will fit in the same spot. You just have to enlarge the existing holes in the door and make two new holes. The mirror on the bottom is 1992 to 2002, and there's three studs. And in the mirror above, 2003 to 2014, there's four studs, and the stud posts are actually larger. Here is a shot of the mirror before removal. And here is a shot of the new mirror when installation is complete. You'll notice that they fit perfectly once the modifications are done. So the first thing after removing the door panel is using a 7/16 socket to remove the three nuts that hold the existing mirror on. It's nice to have a helper to hold the mirror from the outside once you release the three nuts. This is the view of the three studs from the old mirror. Next, take the new mirror and hold it in the exact same position as the old. Two of the studs will line up. Then, have your helper mark where the two new holes have to be drilled. You will need to purchase this step drill bit in order to achieve the large diameter holes. This cost me about $12 at Harbor Freight. I drilled two separate pilot holes in order to accommodate the step bit. Although the studs end up sticking out further than the original mirrors, that is no problem because that black plastic piece will eventually cover them. I noticed that I was unable to attach a nut on the bottom stud, so remove it prior to installing the mirror, and then just use a bolt with a washer. I also needed washers for all the other studs too. It would be easier to remove the bottom stud prior to installing them, but if you didn't, you can still remove it with vice grips. This is the finished product. I hope the video helps, and thanks for watching.